that's really hard to describe someone who was your whole life when you were growing up. He was funny. He loved girls, his daughter in particular, and he would do anything to help anyone. I think I was his favorite. Shh, don't tell my brothers, but I think I was his favorite. We were just very, very close. We were very much alike, which I didn't see then, but I do now. I guess our compassion for other people and wanting to help other people and want to be in the center, but I do want to help. And he was the same way. As my son gets older, he looks more and more like my dad. And I was pregnant with him, my son, when my dad was killed. It was very painful. My daughter, I see a lot of similarities in he and she, just their personalities, the way they're very outgoing and loving. It's kind of sad in a way, but it's nice to know his legacy is carrying on through his grandchildren we never met. When I was in Western Airs, he was definitely with me all the time. He took me all the time. He also was a volunteer in Western Airs. He was a rabbi. He was a mountain man. And he was always there for me. He took me every Saturday early in the morning. We spent all day at Jefferson County Fairgrounds. And that, to me, was very special. And he just was part of it. It was great because he was one of those parents that was involved with their children. We, as a family, all rode motorcycles. We traveled to Florida on motorcycles, my first husband and my mom and dad and I. It was very hot and it was very long, but we drove down there. We also went to California. He rode his bike all the time. We should honor anybody. The military, the police officers, they give the ultimate sacrifice, and their kids have that same pain their whole lives because they're not here anymore. They never got to meet his grandchildren, any of them. So I want him, I want people to know that he loved his job, and I know that he understood that the ultimate sacrifice may happen, but he believed in it enough that he went to work every day. And hopefully people remember that about him and others. I still miss him. It's been 31 years, but it never goes away. I am so glad that people remember what they gave their life, and their family lost something that can never be replaced. Thank you for remembering my dad.